Hello everyone, I am Ultipolo, and today we're gonna make a PyCord bot. So, for you of those that have never made a PyCord bot before, it's quite simple. And today we'll just make a simple bot with a few commands like kick and ban and stuff. And we're going to make slash commands as well. This is why I prefer PyCord instead of Discord.py, as Discord.py don't offer the slash command support as well as PyCord does. So let's get started. First of all, let's make a new bot. Let's go to the Discord developer portal and click on new application. Let's call it test bot. And let's make it personal there. We won't have that option. Test bot. Alright, let's build a bot here. Yes, do it. Alright, so we'll have to try another username. We'll call it PyCord test bot. No, PyCord YouTube tutorial. And let's build a bot here. Let's add a bot. And now we want to have a public bot checked. That one will not be checked, but these will be. We want all of these intents. Now, we need to get the bot's token, so let's click reset token, yes, do it, and then we'll just copy this token. Now, we gotta get started with the decode here. So first of all, let's import Discord. Then we want to import the OS as well, that can be handy in the future. Now, let's define the bot. So we'll call this client. Client equals to discord.bot, and here we want to put the intents. So first of all, here are a few. Intents equal to discord.intents.all. There we go. And here we just want to pass the intents. There we go. Alright, now we have defined the bot. So let's just put client.run token, and the token is the one we copied. We'll just make a variable up here and call it token. In the future we can make secrets and hide the token, because we don't want other people to get the token really. So now let's get started. So jump down here. Let's make just a simple command. So client.command, which we'll use for all new commands. Client.command. I think I got one M too much. Yeah. Client.command. And then we can also pass a description here if we want to. Let's write ping. And what is wrong with this? Oh, nothing really. Client.command ping. Async def. We want to define the command. Let's call it ping. Then we gotta pass CTX as well. We always gotta pass CTX. And now let's just do await CTX dot respond pong. So this will basically just respond to the command with pong. So if you're also doing this in Replit, you want to make sure to do this: pip uninstall discord.py. We don't want to have discord.py. Alright, good. Now instead, we want to install PyCord. So pip install PyCord, like that. And that will automatically install the latest version of PyCord. Here it's installing it now. Let's just give it a few seconds. Meanwhile, we can go to our test server here and just see if we can invite the bot meanwhile it installs this. Let's to invite the bot, we'll go here, then OAuth to URL generator and select bot and also applications.commands. Then we can give it the permissions we want it to have, but we'll just do administrator for now. Then we'll just copy the invite link, paste it, and here we want to add it to our server. Altopolo here now. Yes, I am a human. There we go. And it has now arrived here. So now we have a bot here. We have a bot in our server. Okay, one sec. Now, let's try to run the bot. Let's go to console. And now it adds Discord, of course. Alright, this is an issue with Replit, really. Because we don't want it to install Discord, really. We can just change it here, though. PyCord. And let's see what the latest version of PyCord is, because now it won't work. PyCord equals to... let's see here. Let me check. Let's do... version. There. So here, this core, I'll serve for that and just. And we don't want this core of pi. We want PyCord. PyCord. The Py 2.4.1. 2.4.1. We don't want Discord of Pi there. We want to add PyCord instead, basically. And that's okay, we can have those. Yeah, now let's try do this. Pip uninstall Discord.py. Yes. Pip install PyCord. Here we go. Let's run the bot. And I might have made a mistake here. Here we go. One second. We want to do this intents equals to discord dot intents dot all. Then try that instead. Okay, let's just list the stuff we got. It's really a pain with Replit. Let's do a pip list. Do we have discord.py installed? No. If we don't, we do have PyCord installed. We don't have discord.py. So what seems to be the issue? We don't have disk. We do. Alright, this is kind of weird. Pip uninstall PyCord. Let's proceed. Now pip install PyCord. two point four point one. Pip install PyCord 2.4.1. Okay, this is kind of weird. Let's just do pip install PyCord. There we go. Let's try now. Might work. I think it worked. Let's see. It did work. And we got the slash command thing here. But we also wanted to print a message when we log in. So now let's do this. Client.event async def on ready. Now we wanna do so it prints a message here in the console. Print logged in as, and we can do this. Client.user.name. And we wanna make this an F string as well. Okay, let's stop the bot and run it again. There we go. Logged in as PyCord YouTube tutorial. Now let's try the commands here. Ping. Pong. See? Now we got slash command set up already with the bot. So let's make some simple commands for kick and banning. So we'll do it like this. So let's create a new command by using client.command description equals two. We can just put kick members. And then we want to define the command. So async def kick cdef. And then we also want to pass a member here. We'll call this one member, and this will be a Discord member. So we'll do discord.member. So you can select a Discord member from a select list. And all that. Alright, so now we wanna do here. We wanna try to kick the member. So await member.kick. And I also forgot, we wanna pass a reason here as well, but that can be optional. There we go. So now it's optional to pass a reason. Remember the kick, reason equals to reason. And then await ctx.respond successfully kicked member.mention. I will just do member. Mention might be a bit weird. Successfully kicked member. Dot name. And if this doesn't work, if the bot can't kick the user, for example, if the user is an admin, we'll do this. Accept. Oh wait, ctx. Dot respond. Failed to kick member. So if it doesn't, the bot can't kick the member, it does this instead. It responds with failed to kick member. We can also make this ephemeral. That means that only you can see it, see the message. So let's try this. Let's invite one of my other bots to the server real quick. Let's invite Fetchbot, my main bot I'm working on actually. There we go. And let's check here. It's logged in. So let's try to kick. We don't want to use the fetchbot kick for function. So here, we use kick with the PyCord YouTube tutorial. We try to kick fetchbot with reason haha. There we go, the bot disappeared. It kicked fetchbot. But it can't kick me, as I'm an admin. I'm the owner of the server. Let's try. And let's not pass a reason real. Failed to kick member. See? So this is basic code for kicking, for a kick command. What we could do though, we could add a ban command as well. So that's basically the same, but we just want to replace this with member.ban instead. We'll use client.command description equals to ban members using devban ctx member discord.member and reason equals to none. Try await member.ban reason equals to reason and await ctx.respond successfully banned member.name. We'll make this as well an F string. And except if that doesn't work, we'll just do await ctx.respond failed ban member. Let's make that ephemeral as well. Because no one wants to see your mistakes. Well, maybe they do, but you don't want them to. So here is a basic Discord bot, really. Let's just restart it. And let's see. Let's just jump to another channel to refresh the list. And here, we do have these commands now. We can try to ban. We don't have fetch bot, but it has enough. Ban this bot. Bye-bye bot. But it can't ban itself, of course. So, this is really a basic bot, a basic Discord bot that you can make in PyCord. And make sure to update the stuff as well. But yeah, it's a basic bot. Bye!